is causing significant flooding along the lakefront, including in the South Shore neighborhood.
One of those reporters happens to be Marcella Raymond. She is live there with the latest. Marcella.
Yeah, this is a really interesting weather story, though. The video is amazing. I'm at 72nd Place, where this street ends right at the lake, and those waves down there are relentless, and they are not letting up.
The street in front of our driveway completely collapsed.
Kathy Mikan lives just doors from Lake Michigan. She tells me Streets and Sand was out here and said the manhole covers are not working, so the water has nowhere to go and is clogging the sewers. The waves are a force to be reckoned with. There are reports that windows and homes along the lake have been blown out because of the waves and debris pounding them.
The waves coming not just from the lake, but over the neighbor's property are just amazing.
Streets are buckled with parts of concrete missing or they've completely sunk. This postal truck is half in and half out of the street. It's stuck. Water's up to the doors on cars, leaving them stranded, drivers not knowing when they'll be able to safely move.
My husband has talked to a couple neighbors who are terrified. I mean, they go to their basement like every 30 minutes to make sure there's no flooding.
South Shore Drive between 67th and 69th was closed while crews battled the waves, again working on those sewers as the water crept closer to the street. So I know it's a really cool shot, you know, to get up there close and get some video of the waves, but officials are saying stay as far away as you can. You could slip, you could fall in, anything can happen. They can grab you very quickly and pull you under. You do not want to be anywhere near this tonight. I'm live in South Shore, Marcella Raymond, WGN News.
Good point, Mark.